Hi there, today we're going to be doing a run through on how to install ThermaData Studio and a ThermaData Wi-Fi instrument. To get started, click on the link below to install the software. Open and run the setup, following the prompts throughout the installation. Once finished, close the window down and you'll have a new icon on the desktop called ThermaData Studio. Double click this to open the software. Choose which product to enable. In this video, we'll be focusing on ThermaData Wi-Fi, so we will only tick that. Now that the software is installed, the next step is to unbox your brand new ThermaData Wi-Fi. Inside the box, you'll have a set of instructions, screwdriver, two AA batteries, the ThermaData Wi-Fi instrument itself, and underneath the USB lead. Firstly, we grab the ThermaData Wi-Fi instrument, scan the screwdriver to unscrew battery cover. Insert the two AA batteries provided. And replace the battery cover. The instrument will now power up. Using the USB lead provided, connect one end to the PC and the other to the ThermaData Wi-Fi instrument. On Studio, select the ThermaData tab and choose Connect Instrument to Wi-Fi. Allow time for it to search available networks. If this window doesn't appear, allow time for the PC to recognize the device. Try replugging. Select the available network you wish to connect to and enter the password. Alternatively, you can enter the network name if it doesn't appear on the list. Once entered, press Set Wi-Fi Network. After a few seconds, the ThermaData Wi-Fi instrument will show a network's connection symbol as well as a cloud representing that it is now connected to the Wi-Fi. With the blank active instruments window that opens by default, choose the plus button in the bottom right hand corner and choose ThermaData Wi-Fi. From there, enter the serial number, which can be found on the back of the instrument, and choose Full Access or Read Access. Full access allows full control over settings and customization, whereas read-only access is a view-only permission. In this instance, we'll choose full access. You'll be prompted to push the start button on the front of the device 5 times consecutively. This will generate a unique pairing key, which can be entered into the software. This pairing key is not case sensitive. After a short period of time, the instrument will pair with Studio and will automatically appear in the active instruments window. The next step is to set up the logger with logger settings. To do this, right-click on the instrument and choose Change Settings for this instrument. On this screen, you can change the sample rate, so how frequently the instrument records a reading, the transmission rate, how frequently the instrument sends data to ThermaData Studio, audit check, this will enable the audit check stamp when a start button is pressed during a log, and auto start, this will allow the instrument to start automatically or start when the start button is pressed on the front case. Next, you can change the name of sensor 1 and set the high and low alarm values. Repeat for sensor 2 or disable if sensor 2 isn't required. You'll be prompted with a summary of all settings to check before finishing. Because the instrument and studio will only communicate at each transmission rate, the setting will be queued in the pending requests window. This will count down until the next scheduled transmission. To speed this up, simply press the start button on the front of the case. You will see a small communication arrow in the top left-hand corner of the LCD. When successful, the pending request will disappear from the list and the LCD will change depending on the settings you've just selected. My logger now says press to start, which is what I chose. You can also rename the instrument by right-clicking and selecting Rename this instrument. Time to connect some probes to the instrument. I have two food simulant probes which have been designed to be slow response thermocouple probes, which act the same way as any product that is being stored in a fridge or freezer. The reason we want a slow response is because we want to simulate the temperature of the product in the fridge and not the air inside. In many commercial walk-in fridges and freezers, personnel are frequently going in and out of the storage area, which allows ambient air to rush into the fridge or freezer. We do not want to record ambient air, which will not be a true representation of the temperature of the food we are storing. Because of this, it's also advised to position the food simulant at the deepest point in the fridge or freezer. We offer different lengths of thermocouple probes to cater for all applications and scenarios. Further to this, where are we going to position our ThermaData Wi-Fi logger itself? Because the instrument is using Wi-Fi to communicate, we don't want to put it inside the fridge or freezer because we will most likely lose all signal and not receive any data from the device. Therefore, it's important to position the instrument on the outside of the fridge or freezer and then feed the food simulant probe cable through the seal of the door, or better still, through a pre-drilled hole. The food simulant includes a very fine, heavy-duty PTFE lead, which can fit through the door seal of most commercial fridges and freezers. After the probes are in position, connect the mini plugs into the side of the ThermaData Wi-Fi. Sensor 1 and Sensor 2 are labelled as T1 and T2 on the rear label. Once the probes have acclimatised, simply press start on the instrument. Back to ThermaData Studio. You will see the last captured temperature within the active instruments window together with the high and low limits you set in the logger settings. You'll also see the last time your device updated, along with the access level, which we chose earlier, and the auto archiving status. Auto archiving is a feature within Studio which will save data automatically and eliminate the need for someone to sit there and download data on a regular basis. The setup auto archiving is easy. Simply right click on the instrument you want and choose set up auto archiving for this instrument. If you choose to auto archiving an instrument, this will overwrite the existing logger settings. Simply choose the recording interval, this is how frequently the instrument will record data, and press finish. In auto archiving, the transmission rate is fixed to 4 hours and cannot be changed. This will then queue the changes like before. Simply press the start button on the front case to speed up the process. The auto archiving status will now show as green. To set up where the files are automatically saved, select auto archiving within the home tab along the top window. Here you'll be able to customize how your data is saved. First, we will see a summary of the current setup we have. In this case, none. Secondly, we can set up groups to group instruments together. For example, you may have several devices in a goods in area which you want filed together. Simply enter the name of the group and press add. To remove a group, hover over the group in the list and press the cross. Next, we want to assign a group to each instrument. Choose instruments and simply assign a group of your choice to each of your instruments. Finally, in archiving, you can edit the file directory and then choose three filing folders to sort your data. These are fully customizable. For this demo, I'm going to choose year, month, and group. To see a preview of your chosen directory and path, you can press the preview button. Once complete, press OK. A data file will then appear in your chosen directory at the next time each instrument performs a successful transmission. It's important to remember that ThermaData Studio needs to be switched on for the data to be saved in your file directory. ThermaData Studio can also send email alerts and mobile notifications when a chosen alarm setting on each instrument is exceeded. This allows anyone who needs to know to be informed about a recorded temperature out of limits immediately. First, let's look at setting up email alerts. Click on email alerts within the home tab. Within email settings, you'll be prompted to sync an email address account up with ThermaData Studio. This is the email account that the system will use to send alerts from. If the details are unknown, there are Gmail and Outlook shortcuts at the bottom. If you are unsure on what information is required, please speak to your IT personnel. Once connected, you can test the setup by pushing Send Test Email. Next, choose Alarm Filters. This is where you can choose which instrument and when to receive alerts. You can choose when an alarm limit is either entered or left its alarm for either the high or low limits. You will only get one alert each time the value enters the alarm phase. It will not send continuous alarms. If an instrument is set to auto-archiving, these email settings are locked. You can also select an alarm delay. Email destinations is where you enter the email addresses of those you want to receive the alerts. Remember, these email addresses will receive an email from the synced account containing the email alert. Finally, within ThermaData Wi-Fi alerts, you can enable and disable late instrument alerts as well as low battery alerts. Now let's look at mobile notifications. For this, you will need to download our TD Link app from the App Store. Within Studio, choose TD Link within the ThermaData tab, then enter an email address and a password. If you are a new user, the button will say register, but for existing users, it will say login. Once logged in, it will tell you if your account is linked to this PC or another. Once linked to this PC, go onto the TD Link app and enter the same email and password credentials. On the app, you will be provided with a list of all instruments that have been paired with ThermaData Studio. Any instruments that need attention will be grouped at the top in Instruments in Alarm. This includes any late instruments, low batteries, as well as high and low alarms. Each time an alarm is triggered, a mobile notification on that mobile device will be received. Again, you will not get continuous alarms. Within the app, you can also press on each instrument and it will show you more details. You can also mute individual instruments from alarming here. It's important to note that the values on the TD Link app do not automatically update. To refresh the screen, simply drag down from the top or press the refresh button. TD Link will send alerts even when ThermaData Studio is closed. Once your ThermaData Wi-Fi is set up and logging, it's time to talk about how to view live and downloaded data. When ThermaData Studio opens, the active instruments window will open by default. In this view, you can see all the instruments that are paired to this PC. They will appear in a list of sensors with the last recorded temperature visible. The default view will show both high and low limits, latest reading, last updated, access, and auto archive status. If a temperature value exceeds one of its limits, the row will glow red for a high limit and blue for a low limit. You can also add additional columns by right-clicking and choosing Manage Layout. In here, there is a whole range of other information you can display. We recommend that you always keep ThermaData Studio open to ensure any email alerts and auto-archiving are not interrupted. And with that, keep active instruments open. If you do close this window, you'll have to choose New to open a new session. With active instruments open, you can also view your instruments in a live graph view or table form. To do this, within the Home tab, choose Graph or Data. The data view will lay out all the instruments along the top and begin plotting recorded data as and when it receives it. Remember that if you have multiple instruments, they may plot at different times, creating what looks like gaps, as they were all transmitting at different times. The graph view will plot data in a graph as and when it is received. You can unselect to hide unwanted sensors, and you can also toggle max, min, high, low limits, and visual data points when each graph line is selected. You can also zoom into the graph by using the options at the bottom or by right-clicking and dragging across a particular section of the graph. You can also use these views to view downloaded data too. If you have auto-archiving set up, you'll be able to find and open the saved file, and then with this open in Studio, you can choose the different views. If auto-archiving is not set up, you will need to manually download the data from your logger first. To do this, choose Download within the Home tab and select the logger you want to download from. This can be done on any instrument that is paired with Studio and can remain in location. The download will then queue itself in the pending requests and wait for the next transmission. This can be skipped by pressing the start button on the instrument. Alternatively, you can bring the logger to the PC or vice versa and connect it via USB. Once successful, you'll be prompted with a Save As window where you can edit the file name and change the directory. The data file will then automatically open in the graph view and the data summary view. This file will show everything in the memory of that instrument. To export data to Excel or .csv, it's also very easy to do from here. With the chosen file open, go to File, then Save As. Here you'll be able to change the Save As type and create a new file in that format. Please note that by exporting to Excel or CSV, the data becomes editable. The original ThermaData Studio file will remain untouched and in its original directory. That concludes our run through of ThermaData Studio and our ThermaData WiFi loggers. For any further information, please visit our website.